Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. My dear students, my name is Ms. Mavish Haris and I am your maths teacher from Peshawar Model School. This is your third lecture. In previous lecture, you learn about the sets, examples of set and the methods of set. So today our topic is types of set. You already know about the meanings of set. Set means it is a collection of well-defined distinct object like set of books, set of colors and many other examples. So now come to our my dear students, let's start our topic, that is types of set. There are different types of set according to their numbers of elements. These sets are defined below. The first type of set is finite set. You can also pronounce it finite set. A set whose elements are countable is called finite set. Countable means which can easily be countable. Like, let's see the first example. You have to represent the set with the capital letters and you have to put all the elements of a set in braces and you have to separate it each and every element by comma. Elements or members, both are the same. You already know about it. So let's see our first example. Set A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are only 5 numbers which you have to easily count it. Countable. Now let's see the second example. That is set of books of class 7. There are several books in your bags like your English book, Urdu book, maths book, science book, social studies book. You can easily count it. So all these books are countable. So finite means a set whose elements are countable is called finite set. Let's see our second type, which is infinite set. Infinite is an opposite of finite set. Infinite set, these are the countable number of element, but in infinite set means a set whose elements are uncountable. Uncountable means which we cannot count it is called infinite set. Like in our example, set A is equal to 1, 2, 3, up to so on. Up to so on means there is no end. It is infinite. Infinite. Infinite of another example is like set of stars on the sky, like your hairs. These things are not countable. So all the uncountable elements are known as infinite set. We cannot count the stars on the sky. We cannot count over here. So these elements are uncountable. These things are uncountable. Stars are uncountable. Hairs are uncountable. So all those things which we cannot count it are known as uncountable. A set whose elements are uncountable is called infinite set. Our next type is empty set. Empty set means a set which has no element is called an empty set or null set. Set is written as empty set or phi. Empty set means a set which has no element. Let's see an example. In set A, you have to see the braces, but in this braces, there is no single element, no single digit. It means it is empty. So no element in this set. Now our second example is the set of months with 32 days. You know well about the months. In some months, there are 30 days. In some months, there are 31 days. But there is no single month which has 32 days. So it means set B is empty because there we cannot see a single month which has 32 days. We have also, let's see over another example. Whenever you have to remove your pouch and you have to remove your each and every stationery from your pouch, like your pen, pencil, and there is nothing in your pouch. So it's mean your pouch is empty. It's mean a set which has no element is called an empty set or null set, and it is written as empty set or phi. Example, the set of months with 32 days. Second example, set A, there is no single element which is present in this set, it is empty. Now our next type is singleton set. Singleton set, the word singleton set means a set having only one element. Single means one. So singleton set means a set having only one element is called a singleton set. Example, set A is equal to 2. It means we have to see here in this example, there is only one single digit, which is 2. Now our next example, that is B. I will write here one name here, only one name. That name is Ali. So it means in set A, there is only one digit. In set B, there is only one name. So what is meant by singleton set? A set having only one element is called a singleton set. Now come to our next type, that is equal set. What is meant by equal set? Two sets A and set B are said to be equal if they have the same elements, means there are all the elements, all the members are same and denoted as A is equal to B. Let's see this example. If A is equal to 1, 2, 3, in set B, 1, 2, 3, means we have to see in example A, in set A, there are three elements and all the elements are same. Means all the elements are same means in set A, there are three digits, 1, 2, 3. In set B, second next elements are 1, 2, 3. So in both set, set A and set B, all the elements are same. It means set A is equal to set B. Two sets A and B are said to be equal if they have the same elements. It means in both sets elements are same. So then A is equal to B. Now our next type is equivalent set. Two sets A and B are said to be equivalent if they have the same number. Remember my dear student, if they have the same number of element but not compulsory the same members. Symbolically it is written as A is equivalent to set B. Example, let's see this example. In set A, A is equal to 1, 2, 3. So it is a set of numbers. In set B, it is a set of alphabets. What are the alphabets? A, B, C. So it means they have the same number of element in set A or in set B, but the members are not same. You have see that in set A you see the numbers, but in set B you see the alphabet. So it means it have the same number of elements, but the members are not same. So equivalent set means two set A and B are said to be equivalent if they have the same number of element but not necessarily the same members. Symbolically it is written as A is equivalent to B. Example, if A is equal to 1, 2, 3 and set B is equal to A, B, C. So there are same number of elements but not necessary the same members. So let's come to the activity which is related to the equal and equivalent set. Now my dear students, you have to see some sets. There are five sets. In first set you have to see some shapes, in second sets you have to see some numbers, in third sets you have to see some icons which you have to play in your game, in next set you have again you see some symbols, then in next set you have to see the numbers. There are five sets and your task is that you have to find that which of the following sets are equivalent and also check that are any set equal. So best of luck. Thank you.